Hey, horsey people, we're gonna do finally, I'm getting around to the story of Mr. T and Buddy. I get 1,000 emails. I'm out here giving these guys a bath, and got a picture of Mr. T in my little book here. On this is my medical book, it's got my test for my blood test, it's got my bill of sales. The paperwork for both horses. When they go to the vet, I get a printout of all their shots they got, etc. This is the BLM brand. You go to BLM website and see that. It'll explain how to read the Mustang brand on Buddy's neck. And so I keep this little book so I have information on my horses. So first thing. I just noticed Mr. T don't like my book.
Mr. T, what are you doing? I'm showing him the story about you. You come here. Come here. Quit standing back there like a old scaredy cat. Go on. It's a book. I know.
Remember I told you I think Mr. T's losing his sight? I also think anything white, horses, and this is just my theory, no fact behind it, white reflects light, and I think with horses, when they see something white, it's very reflective. They don't know how deep water is. When they see white lines on the road, sometimes they'll react. When they see white obstacles or white things, they're a little bit spooky, because I think because of the reflection, they have a harder time making out what it is. And there's no real white predators out there that's after them, so when they see something white, it's kind of very unnatural, but that's just my theory. So let's talk about the boys. Buddy, he is a quarter horse. His dad, his sire was Tucker Cash, whoever the hell that is, and his dam was Joanne Jacquelina. So that's who his mom and dad was. He is a... Let me just get behind you here so I can keep an eye on the horses so I don't get in their way there. So we're talking about Buddy, the Palomino there. I did not register him. He's a registered quarter horse. His mom and dad are both registered quarter horse. So if I wanted to register him a quarter horse, I could. I think that registration is BS and I don't like all that. But anyway, so that's Buddy. He was born... when was he born? I looked at this before I turned it on so I would know. Oh, May of 04 is when he was born. So that's how old Buddy is, whatever that is. Let's see, 2014 would make him 10, and it's 15, so he's about 11. A little over 11. So that's Buddy. Now the story behind Buddy is, he has a little bad front tooth. He the lady that was breeding him was breeding a whole bunch of horses, 13 or something. She didn't like geldings. He was the only gelding. He kind of hung around me. All the other 13 mares used to kick his butt, beat him up, bite him. So he was just running around with a herd of mares that used to just kick his butt all the time. So when a human came around, it wasn't beating him up. He kind of liked it. So I started playing with him, messing with him, chasing him when he was a baby. I'm not sure if it was his dad or another stallion I was riding. I got a picture somewhere where I was chasing him when he's just a little bitty baby in an arena, just kind of playing with him and running him around on top of another horse. So, she didn't want him. He was a gelding, and he had a bad, because his front tooth, he either hit it or got kicked, so he had a messed up front teeth, and I guess you can't show a horse if their teeth are bad, because they'll look at their teeth. So, she didn't want him. She said, I like him, he likes him, if I want him, I can have him. So, that's how I ended up with Buddy. And, so, the story of Mr. T, he's the, old Mustang there. Mr. T's a good boy! Let me roll to the paperwork on him so I can figure out what he was. Let's see. Mr. T was born in 1992. February of 1992. He was caught in Granite Range, Nevada. He was captured by a helicopter. It says the reason for the capture was emergency. I'm not sure what that is. BLM, they don't have... The only emergency is they don't want to feed the damn horses, but... Don't get me started on BLM. And so he has a freeze mark, and That's Mr. T don't like when I slam that thing shut. Mr. T, I'm slamming the book. We're closing the book on you. So the story on Mr. T is, and again, you can only go by what somebody tells you. I mean, I've been around Buddy since he was, you know, a little baby, so I kind of know his story. But Mr. T, the story, the guy that gave him to me, had him, sold him like two or three different times. He ended up with him. He had a bunch of property. And people said Mr. T was crazy. When Mr. T was caught, his caught name was Montana. And then for short, people started calling him Tanner. And then I started calling him Big T and Mr. T. So all that is kind of really his real name is Montana. What was his first name? But you never know who changed that or whatever. I mean, it might be on the BLM paperwork. I don't know. But so when I got him, he was, I'm going to say 9 or 10-ish, maybe 11. And he had been through a lot of homes. Nobody wanted him. He was, like I said, he was given to this ranch because people said he was dangerous. They were going to kill him. He was what's called a three striker in the BLM land. If a horse is turned back into BLM on the third time, they consider that a third strike and they kill the horse. So he had had two different owners, and they both turned him. They said he's crazy. He's going to kill somebody. He should be put down. And so the BLM gave him to this guy who had a bunch of land, who kind of worked with the BLM, go out sometime and catch horses for him, etc. So he just gave him this guy. So this guy let him out on pasture with another 100 horses, and he was just running around with a little herd, fighting with other stallions, and he had his little harem out there. And every once in a while, he would be saddled up and kind of just given to somebody with a big bit and a tie down, just to show that they couldn't ride. So if somebody come out that was cocky, I remember one time I was out where they put some dude out there, some dude comes out there and he's all, Mr. I can ride, I'm big and bad. So he gets on a, poor Mr. T, I'm scared.
I'm sorry, Mr. T, I'm sorry.
So I'll keep giving these guys a little bath while I'm yapping here. So, oh, I'm sorry, it ain't that bad. It's, so one time this guy comes out here and he's all young and macho and he's Mr. Horse Rider, he's a tall, lanky dude, and I can ride any horse, throw me on his horse, and so the guy who owned Mr. T, this boy was mine, he goes, let's put him on Montana.
Hey, buddy!
So, sorry, Mr. T, Buddy did that. So, I put him, we get Mr. T saddled up, and we're holding Mr. T by the reins, and we're talking to Mr. Macho, I can ride, and we're like, you ready? Yeah, I got him, go ahead, let him go, I got him. So, Mr. T's head goes straight at me, takes off about 90 miles an hour, stops, turns, the guy's losing his balance, Mr. T turns around, runs back to the barn, stops, the guy falls off, he's hanging on the reins, he's almost coming off, and the guy who's running the place said, okay, let's get him off before he kills him. So he was coming off, we kind of grabbed Mr. T, stopped him, took the guy off him, but Mr. T was kind of known as a difficult horse. And again, he had a big shank bit, tie downs, and the way he was broke, again, this is just a story, when they gelded him, he was gelded by a bunch of Mexicans, I guess, that owned him, and they just tied, you know, the Spanish culture, Mexican culture is very hard on horses. They don't treat them very well. They're not known for their care, their love of animals. They treat them like beast of burden. So anyway, they strap Mr. T down, tie his feet together, throw him on the ground, have somebody stand on his head, walk over to his nuts, grab his nuts, cut his nuts off, and then they let him go and he runs out to pasture and he bleeds and he heals up, and that's how they geld their horses. You know, why pay money for a vet, anesthesia and all that when you can do that? Besides being cruel and mean, but what other reason? So anyway, so that was Mr. T's first experience of getting, because all horses caught in the wild are stallions. And Buddy was a stallion when he was born. I mean, listed as a stallion because he was a male. So until he has his nuts cut off, he's a gelding. So they're both geldings now, but Mr. T, that's how they gelded him. So that was his first experience with humans. And then he was broke really hard, tied down, aggressive. Not a good way to teach a horse. So he learned to fight and be resistance and to be, you know,
Everything was a fight with him. Everything was, you know, aggressive. So that's why people got him, you know, because he's a good-looking horse, and beauty to a horse is death, because you always get idiots that have no knowledge about horses that want the prettiest horses, because they don't understand that pretty horses, you know, pretty is pretty does. So they always buy these pretty horses that they can't handle. They don't know anything about them. They don't know their training. They haven't developed a relationship. They don't buy the horse for the horse. They buy it so they can own a pretty horse, so I can win medals and ribbons and I can show off my pretty horse. So Mr. T got owners like that, I think, that wanted to show him off, and then he was just, you know, a difficult horse that nobody understood or worked with him. Tried the old cowboy way to, you know, make him, beat him, respect my space, all that crap. And so anyway, on his last leg, they said, hey, BLM gave him to him. They said, if we get him back, we're going to kill him. So this guy kept him out on the ranch for a while. I started riding him, started working with him because he was difficult, and I kind of liked working with a difficult horse because I used to work and kind of train some of the other horses, work with some of the wild Mustangs out on this ranch. And so I just I started riding him, and then I got rid of that stupid bit, and you know, the guy was like, dude, you know what? Nobody else likes this horse. Nobody else gets along with him. You can have him. So that's how I ended up with Mr. T. I never bought a horse in my life. Both horses were given to me. That's the stories of Mr. T and Buddy. I know everybody's been wanting that, asking me questions, how old, and oh darn it, I was going to get a measuring tape, because everybody's asking me how tall they are, and I don't know. People come up and go, oh, he's 15'6", whatever, 15'3", 14, whatever. So people are always asking me how tall they are. I've never measured them. And I was going to bring a stinking measuring tape out here so I could measure them and tell you guys how tall they are, but I blew that because I forgot the tape. And now, and then that's, I got another question about rinsing their eyes out. Look, if you want to rinse your horse's eyes out, you got to get them used to water. Get the water soft. You got to get them used to water on their face, controlling them here, and then you can just rinse that eye out just like that on one side, and then go to the other side, put that down, I know, and I can rinse that eye out. The thing you don't want to do when you're rinsing out eyes is get water in the ears. If you squirt it, now I always kind of give them a little eye rub here, because you know, if you go swimming sometime, you get water in your eye, it kind of burns a little bit. If there's sand or something there, it just it burns, so you want to rub your eye. So when I wash my horse's eyes out, I always give them a little rub just to kind of get any water that's out of there. And he seems to like it. He ain't got no choice whether he likes it. I might have a stinking measuring tape here because I get tired of answering all these questions. How tall are they? How old are they? Where did you get them? What color is he? Oh, I forgot color. The color... Mr. T is what's known as a seal brown, because you can tell when he gets wet, he looks dark and black like a seal. And if you've ever seen a seal out on those rocks drying out, they get really light brown. So Mr. T gets light brown when he does it. Buddy is considered what's called a Palomino. Palomino is a color. I call him blonde. And there's different... Some people will call different things for Palominos. Like sometimes he'll get a dark coat and he'll be like a chocolate Palomino. And other times he'll be nice and gold and he'll be a golden Palomino. So it all depends. So I don't think I've ever pulled a tape around these guys. So I don't know what they're going to do. Let me make sure I'm in the camera, because I haven't really looked to see if they're both in the camera yet. Are they in the camera? Yeah, I think they're pretty much in the camera. All right, so let's see how tall they are. Hang on, Mr. T. I'm pulling out a measuring tape. Makes funny noise. I'm going to give him a chance to get used to it first. Mr. T don't want no part of that. I know. All right, so let's see how tall Buddy is. It looks like at the shoulders, he's about 63 inches, whatever that is. Let me let Mr. T smell this, so we got, because he looks a little nervous. All right, so now let me measure Mr. T. Mr. T is about 62 and a half. So, whatever that is, somebody can figure it out. Put it in the comments on how tall they are. Because that's how many inches they are. And hands are 4 inches. So, every hand is about 4 inches. So you divide that by four and you'll get how many hands he is. So that's the story of Buddy and Mr. T. And now maybe I'll stop getting all these questions, because now when I get it, I can just refer them to this video and not have to answer all these questions anymore. All right, Buddy, Mr. T, you're good boys! Dude, finish our bath and get us to pasture. All right, we'll end that there.